But all of us are depending on somebody to watch for us. Tonight, I ask that you would stand with me as I read my little verse of scripture. Would you point your hands at the honoree this evening and say, in just a few minutes, you will know the rest of the story. Isaiah 21. Isaiah 21. Verse 11. The burden of Duma. He calleth to me out of Seir. Watchman, what of the night? Watchman, what of the night? The watchman said, the morning cometh, and also the night. If you will, you will, you will inquire. Inquire ye, return, come. I want to talk to you in these few moments of our sharing together tonight from a subject that's simply entitled, it has nothing to do with the bishopry. Sorry. I need a longer notice for those sermons. I want to talk to you tonight from a subject entitled, The Role of the Midnight Watchman.
All right.
You may be seated. Perhaps if I get another chance in the future, I'll talk about being a bishop. But tonight, I just want to talk to you about the role of the midnight watchman.
Yes, sir.
Dr. Payton, I don't know how to tell you this, but just tell it like it is. You now have two jobs, your day job and your night job.
Yeah.
Watchmen of financial markets and trends, stay alert. Watchmen for food and safety, remain vigilant. And the watchmen who pay attention to planes landing and taking off, please don't go to sleep. Your mistake can be harmful to others. In fact, it could be deadly if you go to sleep at the control. Your mistake can harm others. That plane that fell the other day with all of those athletes that was on it, because somebody wasn't paying attention to the gas tank. And while they were celebrating their latest win, they got on a plane that didn't have enough gas to get to where it was going. Now, one person made the mistake, but 70 people paid for it. When you are in leadership, your mistake can cost everybody else their life. Preacher. Teacher, CEO, president, leader, director, administrator, pulpit chair, bishop. All honorable names and positions that describe the varied roles of ministry in the 21st century church that goes all the way back to the early church. But I ask, when is the last time you went to church and the person who was introducing the speaker said, ladies and gentlemen, our speaker tonight is the watchman in the tower. Nobody wants the title of watchman. We want celebrated titles where people can honor us and be excited about our coming. Travel with me tonight, if you will. Just a little ways, not too far. Travel with me tonight to Iraq. All right. The Assyria of yesterday, a little place called Edom. All right. Today, Iraq is a place of war, but yesterday it was a nation of people called Edom. Those red, sandy folk, shaking in fear of the Assyrian army. Isaiah was so strange, and from chapters 13 to 23, a series of articles give us a picture of the sure tomorrow of God. A parade of nations who will one by one walk the path of a divine plank of judgment. And their names are called. And even though they thought they were tough stuff, God put them in a roll call. Babylon, Moab, Damascus, Ethiopia, Egypt, Arabia, Jerusalem, Tyre, United States, oh, I'm sorry. The message was delayed judgment does not mean forgotten judgment. Charles Edward Jefferson of years past said that the minister is the prophet of the Lord. He is the truth teller and therefore, most of all, must be a truth seeker. Paul Scheer, professor of preaching at Union in Princeton, said, nothing can do people any good without disturbing them, and nothing will disturb them to a lasting effect unless it disturbs them deeply. Yeah. Isaiah engaged in an unusual behavior to gain the attention of Judah. Isaiah reminds me of my mother, who embraced both spanking and psychology. She would say, just keep on. Mm-hmm. You had a mother that said that. Go on. Keep on. Keep on cutting up. Keep on acting up. Don't stop. Keep on. And if you were stupid enough to carry on. Nations coming together, Egypt, Assyria, Israel. What a wonderful day it would be when all of these places in the Middle East will come together at the feet of Jesus. But until then, there's trouble. Isaiah 21, verse 5, prepare the table and watch in the watchtower. The Lord said to me in verse 6 unto me, go set a watchman, let him declare what he seeth. Yeah. Verse 8 said, I stand continually upon the watchtower in the daytime. I'm set in my ward all night. Yeah. Sir, Tylenol PM won't help you when you have an assignment that lasts all night. From the watchtower, he hears the words, behold, here cometh a chariot of men with a couple of horsemen. And he answers and said, Babylon is falling, it's falling, and all the graven images of her gods he has broken into the earth. Isaiah hears the desperate, panicking voice, a voice gripped by fear in the Grand Canyon of darkest nights. Watchman on the wall, watchman, watchman. And he says, I hear the footsteps of the marching soldiers in the darkness. Watchman, what of the night? A voice calling out of the stillness. Watchman, what do you see? It is understood that if you are a watchman in the tower, you have a perspective that nobody else has. You're supposed to see what others can't see and hear what others can't hear and understand what others. People want these titles, but they don't want to work the night shift. God, I wish I could preach at Evergreen tonight. Mm-hmm. They want these titles, but they don't want to deal. They want to be with everybody else. You can't hang with everybody else and have a perspective that nobody else has. Oh, I don't hear nobody today. It does not mean that you're stuck up. It don't mean you don't speak. It don't mean you can't be nice. But when it's all over, there has to be some distance between you and those that you're leading. Otherwise, you can't see what's happening. The misery, the pain, the confusion, the fear. How long will it last? Is there a sign of light? Is it always going to be this bad? Is there a ray of sun anywhere? Watchmen, what do you see? What of the night? Isaiah gives a very short answer. The morning cometh, and also the night. If you will inquire, inquire ye, return and come. The morning cometh. Turn from sin. Seek the Lord. Return from sin. Come to him, and he will receive you. There is a small window of opportunity. And I'm telling you where it is. Now, the Lord goes on to say about the watchman later on. He said, now, watchman, when the sword comes and you fail to tell the people what's getting ready to happen, the blood is on your hand. We don't want that part of the assignment because we want to party with everybody, everybody else. Listen, you can't party with everybody else. If you're the watchman, stay on the tower. Stay out of stuff. Don't get involved in junk. Stay out of that. Somebody's got to be for what? Our problem is that the party is filled with everybody, but there's nobody in the tower. And nobody wants to work the tower because it's lonely in the tower. It's lonely up there. Number one, you got to climb that ladder all by yourself. And it's lonely. And some people can't deal with the solitude of presence. They've got to have people around them. But the watchman's got to learn to hang all by himself.
Yeah.
Can I talk to somebody today? For whom does this voice cry? The voice, the dark. Notice that when darkness falls, that voice does not call for the kings of Babylon. That voice does not cry unto the officials of Edom. It does not cry for neighbors and friends because they too are groping in darkness. To whom does this desperate voice cry? The voice in darkness calls out to the watchman in the tower. You see, people will laugh and joke with you, and then you're on your job, y'all going back and forth, they just laughing, you joking and telling all kind of stuff. And, you know, but when they mother gets sick, they're not going to ask you to pray for them. I don't hear nobody today. And that's why some of you have been on jobs and people have talked about you and laughed at you, called you church person, all that kind of stuff, and they made you feel bad. But when their daddy got sick, they slipped over to you and said, can you pray for my dad? Do I have a witness in the house? Can you pray for my son? My God. They didn't go to their drinking buddies. They came to you. I'm about to get in trouble up in here. Can I talk to somebody? There has to be a difference between holy and unholy, between righteous and unrighteous. A fountain cannot bring forth bitter and sweet water at the same time. Make up your mind whose side.
Bishop Macklin. Yes, sir.
Come on, sir.
Yes, sir, Bishop.
Who can see what others cannot see?
Keep preaching, man.
Night is a dangerous time. Our hearts are all broken over all of the lives that have been lost here just in the last day or so. Lost at night. More crimes are committed
at night.
More fires break out at night. More murders are committed
at night.
More robberies take place at night. More rapes take place at night. Night is a covering. People love darkness rather than light because their deeds are evil. Yes. A watchman is ordered to stand guard over something valuable. God bless my father. He's gone on to be with the Lord, but there was not a greater saint in the world than A.C. Macklin. Boy, my daddy was something else. We moved into a neighborhood in San Mateo, and we were the first African-American family to move in that neighborhood, and we were not welcome. They didn't send the welcome wagon. They sent the junior KKK. They did not want us in town. But my father was such a man that whenever something went down and there was noise outside, my father never told my mama, Helen, go out there and see what it is. That's not what he did. What he did, because he was saved, sanctified, and filled with the Holy Ghost and had an anointing on him, my father would get up and take both his Holy Ghosts and go outside.
Yeah, Doc. Yes, sir, Doc. Yeah, Bishop. Yeah.
He had the Holy Ghost and fire.
Yeah.
if somebody is watching, if he had not been on his J-O-B, they would have broken that house and wiped out his family. But they knew if they were going to get there, they had to get by him. Can I talk to somebody? I'm trying to get through in just a few minutes. Y'all don't have to throw me out. I'm going to get out. God's, brother preacher, watch over cities and fields. They're constantly looking for thieves and robbers. Military or civil security people are there to protect the ancient towns and the military installations from surprise attacks and civil disasters. Watchmen also had the responsibility of announcing the dawning of a new day. What you did not need was a watchman that didn't have a voice. I lost my house. A watchman without a voice can't help you. It's like a guard dog with no teeth. Can I talk to somebody tonight? Can't help you. You need somebody in the tower that can shout down, look out, wake up, trouble is on the way. We live in America today, but we need some people in the watchtower that will stay awake and warn the rest of our families that there's trouble on the way. Yes, that's what happened to Nehemiah. And when they tried to get him, said, come down off the walls. And we ain't coming down. As a matter of fact, we're going to change our strategy. And not only do we have a tool in one hand, we got a weapon in the other. Now, we can either build something or take you out, but we ain't coming down.
Yes, sir, Bishop.
I preached this morning, and I know it's going to be all over the place. I am in big trouble. Dr. Jones, I have messed up. And sometimes I forget that I'm on live stream until I say something crazy. And then somebody said, Bishop, do you know everybody all over the world just heard what you said? So this morning when I was preaching and I stood up and told them I was so tired and America was getting on my nerve and all the craziness that's going on, and I told Glad Tidings this morning, I give you permission to disturb the peace. It's out there now. Don't come to Hayward. But there's going to be the disturbance going on out there. A bishop has to be prepared to disturb the peace. God has not called you to seek agreement with everybody at the table of compromise. I don't hear nobody today. I don't need you to agree with my enemy. I need you to tell me that's your enemy. And don't you forget it. Do I hear anybody in here today? My God, you got to know who's for you and who's against you. Do I have a witness in this house? Everybody smiling is not your friend. Everybody shouting don't belong to you. You got to have enough to be able to have a spirit of discernment that recognizes this is of the devil. Oh, I don't hear nobody today. And I will tell you this, and God knows. Tucker, where's that car? Jesus went to the church. And the Bible said while he was in the synagogue, there was a man there who was demon-possessed. I know I'm in trouble. It don't make no difference now. I'm out there now. He was in church, but he had the devil in him. I don't hear nobody today. And you got to have a leader that recognizes the devil and understand that everybody clapping ain't on God's side.
Keep preaching, Bishop.
Can I talk to you today? And so I've just been wondering how long that man had been a member
of that church.
I wonder how long he had been on the finance committee. How long he'd been in the choir? How long he'd been in the pulpit? He'd been a deacon? How long had he been there full of? Everybody full of the devil ain't in the world. We got some folk full of the devil in church. And don't try to look at me like, ain't no devil in my church. Look at me and say that. Only reason you don't see them is because you haven't climbed high enough in the tower. I am in trouble.
No, I know. Not.
I'm trying to find an exit. 2 Samuel 18, verse 24 through 27, David sat between two gates and gave us a description of the job of the watchman. He said the watchman went up to the roof. The watchman lifted up his eyes, looked. The watchman cried, told the king. The watchman saw another man running, and the watchman called unto the porter. Being a watchman is a tough job. And Brother Peyton, I don't know how to explain this to you, brother, but you better enjoy tonight. Because after tonight, your job assignment begins, and you are starting out not sitting in the pulpit with adjutants all around, waiting on the prelate to come in. Everybody stand, and the prelate is coming. Brother, that lasts for about an hour. When that's over with, you better get back up in that watchtower. You better open your eyes, open your heart, open your mind, and say, God, show me what's going on. I may not like it, but let me say it. God needs somebody that will lift up their voice like a trumpet and show my people. I'm out of here. Isaiah 62 said, I have set a watchman upon the walls of Jerusalem, which shall never hold their peace day nor night. Ye that make mention of the Lord, keep not silent. Last thing you need is a silent watchman. I saw it coming, but I didn't want to say nothing. Get out the tower. I was going to say something, but people, they may not like me. Get out the tower.
You ain't got no voice, God.
I don't hear nobody. God gave us a trumpet to blow and not a fiddle to play. If you ain't going to blow the trumpet, get out of the tower. Let somebody else get up that ain't scared. Let somebody else get up and declare the glory of God and the power of God in this world that we live in. Is there anybody here that's not scared? Jeremiah 6 and 10, to whom shall I speak and give them warning that they may hear? Warning cometh before destruction, and a haughty spirit before a fall. We got a whole lot of folks just jumping in church, but man, you better stop jumping long enough to tell folk that hell, the road to hell, is filled with good intentions. I don't hear nobody the other day. I got in trouble in St. Louis the other day there at our national convocation. I was in big trouble. I said, Lord, I ain't even looking back. I ain't gonna look back. I'm not gonna even look at nobody behind me. So I got off the pulpit and preached on the floor. And I announced to everybody, to their shock, that the rapture has not been canceled. Deal with it. Jesus is coming back again. And all of the preachers who've taken everybody's money, driving their cars and living in their house, but then they don't have no voice to stand up and say, thus say the Lord, you are a hypocrite.
Yes, sir.
Oh, I don't hear nobody today. Can I talk to somebody for just a little while? If you're going to stand in the pulpit, if you're going to be a watchman, then watch. Open your mouth, open your eyes, open your heart, and watch. Let me get out of here. It's dark. It's dark. We won the first war in Iraq because somebody invented night goggles.
Yes, sir.
Night goggles turned the whole war around because it allowed people to see the enemy at nighttime.
Yes, sir. Doc.
I know there's some folks that if they don't get that man out of here, I'm going. Hallelujah. Let me close. Brother Preacher, you must not only minister to people, but you must minister to those who minister to people. And when you take on the role of a bishop, it's not so you can just drive around and look important. That means pastors look to you and you have to minister to pastors. And you minister to pastors different than you do ministering to the congregation. I'm just about through now. You are the encourager of the encouragers. Now let me close.
It's clear, Doc.
Last Sunday, millions went to church. They sat down in the pews. They looked up on the platform. Preachers couldn't hear them, but I'll tell you what they were saying. They were saying, "Hey, you in the tower. I see you there. Mr. Man in the tower, did you talk to God last night?
In the tower, Doc. Come on, Bishop.
Mr. Watchman, did God tell you what's going on in my neighborhood? Mr. Watchman, can you help me understand what's going on? Because I don't understand it. When my kids were on drugs and their pants were sagging and they were using drugs, they just said they was a bunch of drug addicts. And they built more cells and put them in it. But now that the rich kids are strung out, they don't talk about drugs. Now they say we have a problem in America. Now they want to have a national program to get people off of the drugs that we buy from Walgreens. I know that's not popular, but that's the job of the watchman. It's the job of the watchman to call in check the prisons in America that now sell stock. And you can buy stock in a prison. Make money. Everybody that say they want to help you ain't trying to help you. I need a watchman to tell me, watch out for what's going on over here. And I close. I've got to close. It's over now. So I close by saying this. I hear the Lord giving you a closing word, Brother Preacher.
Leave us right, Bishop. Leave us right now.
I hear the Lord.
Yes, sir.
Saying to us, arise, shine, for thy light has come. I know it's dark.
Go for it, Bishop.
But get up. I've got some light for you.
Come on, son.
People may not like you.
Come here,
but when the light shines, they're coming in your direction. I hear the Lord saying, behold, I stand at the door and knock. And if any man will open the door, if any woman will open the door, I'll come in and sup with them and they with me. I hear the watchtower shouting out, come now and let us reason together, saith the Lord. I wish I had a few preachers that helped me shout, come on and let's reason together. If my people who are called by my name come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. The thief comes to kill, to steal, and destroy. But I'm in the watchtower, and I came to tell you that Jesus has come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. Is there anybody here that wants a real preacher in the watchtower? Is there anybody here that wants a real saint in the watchtower? Is there anybody here
that wants a real move of God in your life, then you ought to lift your hands and say, God, I want the real thing. I want to know the truth, because the truth will make me free. Lord, whatever it is, I want it. Whatever the problem, I need to know it. Whatever the situation, my God will bring me out all right. Somebody point your hand and say, stay in the tower. Open your mouth and let God fill it. Now take your right hand and lay it on somebody's shoulder and tell them, God is speaking to you. God is calling you out and calling you up. God is separating you from all the rest. God has an anointing that only works in the life of a saint. God wants to give you power. Somebody shout, yeah.
Mr. Macklin, don't you quit.
Bye. Somebody lift your hand and say, have your way in this place. Is there anybody here that will allow the Lord to interrupt our service? Is there anybody here that would allow God to interrupt this service? Somebody shout yes. If you praise him, he'll interrupt this place. If you magnify him, he'll interrupt the service. If you shout unto the Lord, I dare you to shout. I dare you to open your mouth. If you praise him, see what happens. If you praise him, he'll show up. If you praise him, he'll bring you out. Say, yeah, 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 yeah.
Aren't you glad we got a watchman on the wall? Aren't you glad that we got somebody that's got some good spiritual eye? Have I got a witness? Turn to somebody and say, I'm glad. I'm grateful. I'm thankful for the watchman. Yeah. Yeah. Hallelujah. Oh, God, we pray. Let's say amen. I tell you, we have had a glorious time here this afternoon. Have I got a witness? I mean, we've had a good time. Oh, God, did the preacher preach? Huh? You ought to be glad you got a watchman who watches for your soul. Amen.